So here's the question, check this out. A lot of people have been saying that square root of 9 is equal to both plus and also minus 3. Well, if this is the case, then I would like to ask you guys this. Start with 3, and that's write this down as square root of 9. Of course, this is equal. And now, because we have square root of 9 right here, let's use the negative 3 from here. So we're saying that this is equal to negative 3. And you know what? We are saying that 3 is equal to negative 3. Whoa, look at that. Here's the issue for this kind of things. When we have an operation, this right here, it's the square root, it's defined to be the positive square root. So we do not have the negative 3, all right? However, if we're talking about questions, such as solving equations, let's say x squared is equal to 9, then in this case, we can have two solutions. The solutions are x is equal to plus or minus 3. So this right here, we have two answers, but when we have an operation, it's just one answer. And now you might be wondering, when we have square root of I, why do we write it as both plus and also minus the 1 over square root of 2 plus and 1 over square root of 2i like this? Well, I will say that because we're dealing with complex numbers, things like that. So if you know for sure that we're talking about complex number, everybody is cool with that, then you can do the plus or minus.